Half a day students, I am Governor Lou Leon Guerrero. You all have been through a year of big changes. We've had to adapt and make big changes to keep our families and our island safe. But with change comes opportunity and a chance to try new things like PBS University. While Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio and I will continue to do our part to keep our island safe, you students have a part to play as well. Your part is to keep learning and to keep up with your lessons. That's why I am happy to see you here ready to learn with PBS University. PBS University is a way to bring a continuous educational curriculum to you while you stay safe at home during this time. To help you keep up with your studies, we asked our friends at PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education to put together this episode. Thank you for doing your part and have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by PBS Guam and the Guam Department of Education in conjunction with public school teachers. These lessons are created to provide both parents and students with a unique educational experience while helping students to continue learning at home. PBS University, next on PBS Guam.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Come along, let's sing a song. We'll have a great adventure. We'll have a great adventure.
Numbers,
letters,
science, things, all that we can do. Help you deal with how you feel. Share with us too.
It's super cool and just like school.
Our awesome learning adventures. So grab a friend, the fun will end. Our awesome learning adventures. Awesome learning adventures. University!
Half a day, students, and mabuhay! That's a greeting in Tagalog. I'm Mrs. Borja, your 3rd through 5th grade literacy teacher. I love reading and writing and having fun, and I hope you do too, because here we go! Here's a question. What's a question? We ask them all the time, every day. But why? Is anyone eating these? Can I? Ooh, what's inside? Ew. What is it? Thank you. It's a sweater. Ew. So today is all about questions and using them to show understanding. You can ask and answer questions about anything, but in school, it's such a great way to show that you get what you're reading. After today's lesson, you should be able to say, I can ask and answer questions to show that I know what I read. We can ask and answer questions at any time before, during, or after we read. And the most common questions we can ask are, who, what, when, where, why, and how, also known as the 5 W's and 1 H. The who is the person or people in the story or article. The what refers to what they are doing. When is what you ask to find out the date or time something happened. Where is the location. Why asks why there is a problem, and how asks how the problem was solved. Not only can you ask questions at different times while reading, but the answers can come from different places. Answers can be found in the text, in your head, or from another source. Let's practice. Nick picks a pet. Wow, just after reading the title, I already have a couple of questions. Who is Nick? And what kind of animal does Nick pick? I guess we have to keep reading. And I want you guys to ask questions while we read, and hopefully we'll be able to answer them. One summer day, Nick and his dad went to the animal shelter. Nick was so happy that his parents agreed he was responsible enough to adopt a pet. This part might make you wonder what kinds of things made his parents think he was responsible. Doesn't say in the story. So maybe that's a question someone else could help us with, like our parents. As they walked around the shelter, Nick started to get a little worried. He realized there were so many adorable animals in need of a home that he didn't know how he could possibly choose one. One of the volunteers suggested that he spend time talking to and playing with several animals in order to find the perfect one. Nick pet some cats and tried to play with some dogs. Suddenly, a fluffy brown puppy jumped right into his arms and licked his face. He knew this was the pet for him. "Looks like you didn't have to pick a pet after all. Your pet picked you," said the volunteer. "Come on, Peanut," Nick said happily. "Let's go home." All right, let's ask and answer some questions. Who is Nick? Right, the main character. And what was he doing? Picking a pet to adopt. When? Yes, one summer day. Where? An animal shelter. Good job. Why was there a problem? Yes, it was hard for him to choose a pet. And how did the problem get solved? Right, the pet ended up picking him. That was great, everyone. And you know, by asking and answering these questions, you really showed me that you understood what we were reading and you completed our goal for today. Remember, I told you that by the end of the lesson, you would be able to say, "I can ask and answer questions to show that I know what I read." And you know what? You guys did just that, so awesome job. So, to review, you can ask and answer questions before, during, or after reading. And the most common questions are who, what, when, where, why, and how, also known as the 5 W's and 1 H. And the answers to these questions can be found in the text, in our heads, or from another source. You know, there are lots of other ways to show how much you understand what you're reading. For example, summarizing, making inferences, paraphrasing. Catch me again next week and we'll hang out more, learn more, and have lots more fun. Until then, be good, read books. Bye.
Hey there, everybody. Welcome to PBS University. Today, I'd also like to say Casalelia to all of you awesome people from Pohnpei. A good friend of mine from Pohnpei taught me that Casalelia means hello. I'm Mr. Borja, or you can just call me Mr. B, and I'll be your 3rd through 5th grade math teacher today. So, who's ready to do some learning on an awesome math adventure? You are? All right, let's go. Now, to get started, we need to know what we're about to learn, right? Of course. We'll do this by reading our I can statement. I can show how addition is connected to multiplication. And all that means is that you will show how to use addition to understand multiplication. All right, so I'm here in my kitchen and I'm packing up some cookies that I just baked. I want to share these with three of my best friends. And I think I'll give each of them 4 cookies. I made a huge batch here, but I wonder if it really is enough. How many cookies will I need? Can you help me find out how many I need? Oh, thank you so much. Well, I think the best way is going to be for us to multiply. Okay, I know. Some of you might not know how to multiply, but don't worry. That's why we're here. When we multiply, we combine equal groups of something, and for us, that's cookies. So we can find how many in all. And to figure out how many cookies I need, we need to make equal groups. I'll put them in these bags, so each bag will be 1 group. And I said I'm sharing these with 3 friends, so we'll need 3 bags to make 3 groups. Next, I said that I want to give each friend 4 cookies. So let's put 4 in each bag. All right, let's see what we've done so far. We made 3 groups with 4 cookies in each group. Or we can just say that we made 3 groups of 4. All right, here it is. This is where we show how to use addition to multiply. We can also think of multiplying as repeated addition or adding the same thing over and over again. Using our bags of cookies, it would look like this. 4 cookies plus 4 cookies plus 4 cookies. If we start to make an addition number sentence out of that, it would look like this. 4 plus 4 plus 4. Now, how many 4s are we adding there? Okay, 1, 2, 3. That's right, 3 4s. Now, let's take those 3 4s and make them into a multiplication number sentence. We use the X as the symbol for multiply. And when we see the X, we say times. So we have 3 times 4. But our number sentence is missing something, isn't it? Yep, it needs an answer. And to find the answer, well, we can go back to our bags of cookies for some help. All we have to do is add them or count them all up. Here we go. 1 bag of 4 plus another bag of 4. Well, that's 4 plus 4 equals 8. Plus another 4, well, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 4 plus 4 plus 4 equals 12. That means that 3 times 4 equals 12. So if I want to give 3 friends 4 cookies each, then I'm going to need 12 cookies. Ooh, and it looks like I made way more than 12. So you know what that means? I can keep some for me too. I love cookies. Okay, wait. Now, one thing that you have to remember is that this only works if each group has the same or equal amount in it. So if it's something like 3 plus 2 plus 3, that's not multiplying. Now, just so I'm sure that you're sure about what we just did, maybe I should give my three friends 6 cookies each. I have a lot of cookies here. So how many cookies will I need? Well, let's make 3 groups of 6, or 6 plus 6 plus 6. And to show that as a multiplication number sentence, what would it be? Right, 3 times 6. Now we can solve it. Let's do that. So 6 plus 6 equals 12, plus another 6. Well, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 3 times 6 equals 18. I need 18 cookies. Sweet job, boys and girls. So there it is. You showed how addition is connected to multiplication. I really hope you enjoyed yourself today and that you'll come back and join me, Mr. B, on another awesome learning adventure. Stay safe, everyone.
Aloha, boys and girls. Don't mind me. I'm just looking at this little earthworm wiggling its way into the soil of my flower pot. I guess this is its home, but I wonder how it survives in there. By the way, aloha means hello and goodbye in Hawaiian. My name is Mrs. Christine Palma, and I will be your 3rd, 4th, and 5th grade science teacher. Welcome to PBS University. Today's lesson will be on ecosystems. Oh, that's right. This little worm is living in its own ecosystem. But what is an ecosystem? Today we will learn how to describe what an ecosystem is, name at least 3 types of ecosystems, identify the living and non-living parts of an ecosystem, and identify the 3 main things that living organisms need in order to survive. What exactly is an ecosystem? An ecosystem is a community of living organisms interacting in their environment. Many people only think about animals when they learn about ecosystems. Remember Mr. Earthworm in my flower pot? The reality is an ecosystem has animals, plants, fungi, algae, and even bacteria. And it also includes non-living things like rocks, water, soil, sunlight, climate, and the land formation. You see, some animals like Mr. Earthworm need to hide in between or under rocks, and sometimes they hide inside dead trees. Animals also need to drink water, and some animals live in the water. Air is another non-living part of an ecosystem, and well, all animals need air. The area or place where an organism lives in an ecosystem is called a habitat. A habitat has all the living things and non-living things an organism needs in order to survive. For example, if a cow needs to eat grass and the place they live in, their ecosystem, no longer has grass, they have to move somewhere else or they may starve and die. Can you guess what 3 main things living organisms need in order to survive? That's right! They need food, water, and air. Wow, that's a lot of stuff to remember. But stay with me, I'm going to show you the many different types of ecosystems in 3, 2, 1. This is a desert. Wow, so much sand. It looks very hot and dry here. Ooh, except for that watering hole. Do you see many trees? Not much. Snakes live here, and so do camels. Camels can survive in the desert. Do you think their humps store their food and water? Wow, these animals have adapted to such harsh environments. Grassland. I bet the land is covered with lots of grass and some trees. animals have learned to find their food and water in this dry habitat. See? Giraffes have long necks to eat leaves from tall trees. I think that's pretty neat. Ah, the rainforest. I love how green and beautiful this place is. It is home to many unique plants and animals. This monkey is able to escape and hide in the tall trees. There are lots of food choices for each animal here. That's how they survive. Tundra. There's so much ice. This place looks way too cold for me, but not for these animals. They have very thick and warm fur and feathers. Many of the animals here have long bodies and short arms and legs to help them keep warm. I bet those penguins enjoy their meal. The beautiful coral reef. It is made up of lots and lots of coral. Many creatures of the sea live here because of the warm water and a buffet of food. There are lots of nooks and crannies for animals to hide in. These fish have learned to find their way through the rocks and coral. Let's review the different types of ecosystems. We have the desert, grassland, rainforest, tundra, and coral reef. But wait! In my backyard, I have a little mini pond. Let's take a look and observe this little ecosystem. Can you identify the living organisms we can see? Look, there's fish, snails, water plants, and algae growing on the side of the pot. What are the non-living things? There's water, soil for the plants, sunlight, and air. Did you know that the water plants produce air for the water so that the fish can survive? And look here, the snails are eating the dead parts of the leaves. Snails also eat the algae. As for the fish, they can eat bugs that land in the water, but mostly, I just give them fish food. All right, boys and girls, what do you say we build a diorama of a rainforest together? Wouldn't that be so much fun? But first, let's gather some materials together. Let's go. First, you will need a shoebox with a lid, some green paint and a paintbrush, tacky glue, dark dirt or soil, small pebbles or rocks, dead grass or leaves, rocks covered in moss, fake animals, fake small aquarium leaves, and a full page printout of a rainforest wallpaper that you like. Let's get started! Joining me today. I hope you had a lot of fun building ecosystems and for helping me build a diorama. I hope I get to see your creation of an ecosystem one day, but if I don't, just remember, you are so smart, you are so awesome, and you are so special. Have a wonderful day and aloha!
Hafele students, welcome to PBS University. My name is John Fernandez, and I'm the superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. These PBS University lessons are made to help you to continue learning. The teachers here prepared fun lessons on science, character education, math, English, and more, and they made it for you, the students of Guam. We're very grateful to them for their instruction. We're also thankful for you students, parents, and guardians who are watching. Remember, stay safe and healthy, and we'll see you soon in the next school year. Thank you.
a day, everyone. That is CHamoru for hello. Welcome to Mrs. Gian Chan's social studies classroom for grades 3rd through 5th. Today, we are going to be learning about something so special, about celebration. Wait a minute, are you distracted by my crown? Pretty, isn't it? It was made for graduation. Graduation is something to celebrate, and that's why today's lesson is going to be so exciting, because it is going to be a celebration, fiestas. It's going to be about the CHamoru culture. Now, there are so many things to celebrate about the CHamoru culture. Today, we will be focusing on their latte stones, the language of their people, Biba, and their fiestas. Now, before we can move on, let's make sure that we have our notebook and our pencil so that we can be sure to take notes and review what we learned today. Our I can statements for today are, I can identify the CHamoru culture and what makes it special, and I can share with others what I learned about the CHamoru culture. So I hope you enjoy today's lesson on celebrating the CHamoru culture. Let's go.
The latte stones are a symbol of strength and identity. They are known to be unique to Guam and the neighboring Mariana Islands. The latte stone is comprised of two stones. The capstone is called the tasa, and the shaft or pillar is called the haligi. These pillars were made of limestone, basalt, or sandstone, and they vary in height. Now, during the ancient times, the latte was a foundation for homes and important buildings. On Guam, you can find the latte stones in the Angel Santos Memorial Park in the capital village of Hagatnya. Guam's largest latte stone is the Latte of Freedom, which rises 80 feet above Guam and is located in Ataloop. Language is vital to human connection. It is one of the most important parts of any culture. It is the way by which people communicate with one another, build relationships, and create a sense of community. Learning a language reflects the pride of a culture. In Guam, CHamoru is the native and spoken language of the CHamoru people. Let's practice some of the CHamoru phrases. Buenos dias, good morning. Buenas tardes, good afternoon. Buenas noches, good evening. Si zuus maasi, thank you. Hungan, yes. Ahi, no. Dispensa zu, excuse me. Huguaidza how, I love you. Para, stop. Biba, cheers. Adios. Goodbye. Fiestas are a big part of Guam's culture. It truly demonstrates Guam's people as cooperative, entertaining, and hospitable. In addition, the fiesta table is a multicultural display of Guam as a melting pot of people coming together. Although Guam's fiestas sometimes takes weeks of preparation, you will always find the spirit of Inafamalik within the people. Inafamalik is a term they use for family togetherness, cooperation, and interdependence. The values of working together to achieve a common goal of celebration is always a success. One of the best parts of a fiesta is when the host asks you to balutan, which means to wrap the delicious food you just ate to go as a sign of appreciation for attending the fiestas. Fiestas are surely a thing you wouldn't want to miss.
Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes.
Tamana tefen celebra y culturosa.
Oh, mauri ke no na question. Sinya tana serbi finota kera haani. Sinya lokui by who is the reality ho?
Is this Masi Tata?
Ogo Mas Leo.
I love my CHamoru culture because of its rich history.
Half a day, my name is Carson. I am Filipino and CHamoru. My favorite CHamoru food is chilaquiles.
This lei is done. I am now ready to give it to my graduate. Now, folding these dollar bills are quite time consuming. It can take a lot of time, especially if you're not used to it. But I believe with much practice, patience, and commitment, we can achieve something pretty like this or like this. That could be with anything in life. We just have to be dedicated. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson on the Chamorro culture as it focused on language, Latte stones, and fiestas. Let's continue to celebrate cultural diversity and let's continue to practice our Chamorro phrases. Until next time, Biba Chamorro! Adios, everyone!
Half a day. That means hello in Chamorro. Hey guys, Ms. Torres here, your fifth grade teacher with PBS University. Did you know that you take your character with you everywhere you go? Join me today as we learn how to build character. Let's start with our I can statements. Our first one is, I can explain what character is. Our second one is, I can identify positive and negative qualities. What? You're asking me, what is character, Ms. Torres? Why is it important? Let me think of some words that maybe you could use to figure it out. Let me see. Kindness, respect, unfair, bossy, honest, and caring. How about using those clue words to help you figure out what character is? Huh? Okay, you need a few more clues? Let me think. How about responsible and courageous and selfish? What do those words have in common? Still trying to figure it out? Okay, let me give you some help. So all of those words together, they're qualities. Qualities that tell us who we are. They basically shape our character. So now that we know what shapes our character, I think you might be asking, well, what qualities do I actually have? Or what qualities do you have? So I wonder if we could figure that out. Do you know where you get them from? Think about it. Okay, I'll give you a hint. So you know when you're in a situation and you have to make a decision and you're not really quite sure what road to go down? And you have to pull something from inside to help you make that decision? Do you see where I'm going with this? You're absolutely right. The qualities, where do you get them? From the decisions you make, from the situations that happen in your life. So think of it this way. When we build character, it depends on the situations that happen in our lives. So for example, if there's a situation in your life and you're not quite sure how to deal with it, you pull from within, you pull from you, your character, to decide how to handle it. Would you rather pull a good quality or a not so good quality? Like a positive quality or a negative quality? So think of the situations that you're in, okay? And let's go back and revisit the clue words that I gave you earlier when we were trying to figure out what character actually is. And can you tell me whether that quality is a positive or a negative? Let's see. One of the words I used was kindness. What do you think? Positive? Negative. Good job. It's a positive quality. How about unfair? Oh, spot on. Negative. Let's do a couple more. How about honesty? Oh, good job, right away, positive. And, oh, how about this one? Bossy. Oh, yep, that's a negative one for sure. So now that you know what character is and what some positive qualities are and what some negative qualities are,
I want you to know that you can actually build character by your own efforts. But guess what? You can also build your character through your interactions with others. So let's watch this video with Lauren and her sister Lexi. What I'd like for you to do is, as you're watching, try and pull out some positive, yay, qualities that they talk about or you see throughout the video. Okay, I'll see you in a bit.
My name is Lauren and I'm 14 years old. My girl power is being a leader in the community and helping others.
My name is Lex, I'm 10 years old and my girl power is doing gymnastics.
It takes a lot of girl power to kind of get along with people in general, but especially a sibling, because everything's a lot more personal. Like, they see everything you mess up, every time you mess up, they see that. And you have to kind of learn to kind of respect each other's differences, too.
Try that again.
Yeah, definitely get over, like, the sharing thing.
It's just gonna happen.
We'll do, like, Sister Sundays. Like, oh, yeah. So last weekend, I think, right?
Yeah.
We did it. Like, we try and do it, like, every couple months or so. Yeah. We'll do, like, a Sister Sunday where we just spend, like, the whole day with each other. Like, and we just do our bucket list.
Yeah.
How's school?
Good. Oh, so we have this essay contest for Scholastic. So you write how you broke barriers using the 9 words that describe Jackie Robinson.
That should be interesting. My sister definitely has that quality of not really caring what other people think about her, and I definitely wish I kind of had that quality more.
I do tumbling classes at TAG. And I really enjoy them because I feel like I get to get all my energy out, and it helps me build my confidence too when doing other things.
You just have to like go for it. I'm not really scared when I'm doing it because I know there's always going to be someone watching me. So I just think go for it and you got it.
Good work.
I'm really proud of her because she's doing something. She's not just like sitting around being lazy. She's actually out there playing an instrument, helping others, and just making other people feel good.
It's really nice to kind of share my passion for music with people at the rehab center. It's nice to kind of get them to come out and really just listen to something different. Some of the residents will clap at the end when we're done, some will smile, and some actually will like just kind of peacefully fall into a sleep. That's how you know you do good, when everyone can just kind of relax. Sometimes when I'm playing, I like to kind of pause just to let the note, like the silverness of the note, just kind of hang out. It's something you learn once you start developing a better tone. You kind of just like to pause and then you hit the final note.
There you go. Try to get 2 more. 1. 2. Good job. Good work.
When I hear the word girl power, I think that girls can do whatever they want to do.
True power is knowing that every hour, every second, every day is a chance for you to learn something new. True power is learning that what really matters lies within you.
Embrace your girl power.
See how to share your girl power at unctv.org/ncgirlpower. We gratefully acknowledge our Girl Power campaign partner. Support for Girl Power made possible in part by the Margaret Pickard Service Fund.
Hey, welcome back. Pretty good video, right? I saw some pretty good positive qualities in that video. And I'm wondering if you came up with some of the ones that I came up with. I saw helping. I also saw respect and sharing, and I heard Lauren speak about passion. And you know how the relationship between Lauren and Lexi, it was very, very encouraging. Don't you think? Yeah, pretty good example of building character, right? I really like what Lauren said at the end of the video, that true power is learning that what really matters comes from within. What an awesome quote to end our time together today. So I want you to remember, you take your character with you everywhere you go. So until next time, bye.
A-un, a-dos, a-un-dos-tres. It's Chamoru time in PBS University. It's Chamoru time in PBS University. It's Chamoru time in PBS University. Woohoo! Half a day, everyone. My name is Senor Al, and our friend with us today is...
Inatan!
Woohoo! Inatan, when's your last day of school?
Oh, my last day of school is going to be on Monday.
Ooh, Monday in Chamorro is Lunes.
Lunes means Monday in Chamorro? That's so cool! Friends, Lunes means Monday in Chamorro. Do you want to try saying that?
Good job, boys and girls.
Good job.
Inatan, let's say the days of the week in Chamorro.
Wow, that sounds so cool. Come on, friends, join us. Sunday.
Sunday is Domingo. And that doesn't mean you pick the mango from the tree.
The mango tastes good with the salt and pepper.
I like that one. That's a good line.
Jesus maasi.
On Domingos, I go to church on Domingos. What do you do on Domingos?
Domingo, I usually eat pancakes and bacon for breakfast.
Oh man, I'm feeling hungry already.
Me too. Monday.
Lunes. Lunes means Monday in Chamorro.
Wow, on Lunes, it's gonna be my last day of school.
Woohoo, I bet you're excited, huh?
Oh, yes I am.
Yeah, what are your plans for the summer?
For summer, I plan to do a lot of stuff, but I am going to do summer school.
Ooh, that sounds good. All right.
On Tuesday.
Tuesday. Tuesday means Matis in Chamorro.
Wow, on Matis, I like to watch movies with my brother.
Oh man, me too. Netflix?
Hulu. Wednesday?
Wednesday, yeah. Wednesday is Metcalis!
Woo!
What do you do on Metcalis?
On Metcalis, I usually do my work for school, but in the summer, I plan to go surfing with my dad and brother.
All right.
Thursday!
Thursday is Webbis!
Ooh, on Webbis, I love to read in the morning.
Oh, wow. I go to choir practice on Webbis.
Cool! Friday!
Friday is my favorite day. Friday is Betness! Woohoo! You like Betness?
Yes, I do. On Betness, I go hiking and swimming with my Uncle Key and my cousin Ela.
Awesome.
Me and my brother always go.
Really? Okay. On Fridays, that's my favorite day of the week because it's weekend!
Oh, woo-hoo! Yeah! Sabalu.
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 Sabalu. Sabalu.
Lu. Lu. Means Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely correct. Sabalu means Saturday.
Woo! Yeah.
That's the day I go to parties.
Me on Saturday, I do a lot of different stuff. Sometimes I paint. Sometimes I go on my computer. But there's always one thing I always do. And that is... eat hash browns and sausage!
Woohoo!
So
awesome!
Good. Ooh, I have an idea. I want to sing you a song. I've just been like hearing all of the weeks, like the days of the week, and I want to sing you a song.
Oh, awesome!
Want to hear it?
Yes!
Okay. There are 7 days, there are 7 days, there are 7 days in the week. There are 7 days, there are 7 days, there are 7 days in the week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Whoa, that's a cool song, Inatan.
Thank you, Jesus Maasi.
Do you want to hear the Chamorro version of that?
Oh, yeah.
All right, follow along. Boys and girls. If you know this song, follow along. It's called Sheti Dias. Uno, a dos, a uno, dos, tres. Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Kisimana, Damengulunis, Matis Metcolis, Webis Betnis, Sabalu, Damengulunis, Matis Metcolis, Webis Betnis, Sabalu, Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Kisimana. What do you think?
Wow, that is such a cool song.
Maybe we should ask our friends to join us. What do you think?
Yeah, let's sing it together.
Awesome. Uno, a dos, a uno, dos, tres. Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Shetidi, yes, Kisimana. Damengulunis, Matis Necolis, Webis Betnis, Sabalu. One more time. Damengulunis, Matis Necolis, Webis Betnis, Sabalu. Shetidias, 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 Kisimana. Awesome. Woo! Good job, boys and girls.
So, today, we learned the days of the week in Chamoru. Sunday means Damengo. Monday means Lunes. Tuesday means Matis. Wednesday means Metcalis. Thursday means Webis. And Friday means Betnis. And finally, Saturday means Sabalu.
Sabalu, 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 Lu, Lu. I like that word. Woohoo.
That's all for today. I hope you guys practice using the 7 days of the week in Chamoru. Adios!
Adios, from the good.
Adios!
Fast, fun facts. Fast, fun facts. With Mr. Ernest Pachoco.
Mabuhay, everyone! And that means literally to live. Like to go out and find an adventure. At least that's what it means to me. And you and I are going to take an adventure today for our fast fun fact two. The Philippines. You're like, why does that hat represent the Philippines? Well, let me tell you. This is a rice picking hat that they use in Banaue, the rice terraces of Banaue. Now, what is the rice terraces of Banaue? It is one of the 8 wonders of the world. It's considered by the world community to be a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Why is it so cool? Well, let me tell you. It is literally mountains. Lots and lots of mountains that were terraced. That means they carved the mountains to look like steps all over the mountains, every single mountain. And it was all done by hand. And it was created or started about 2,000 years ago, which is a wonder in itself. How do you carve an entire mountain with just like rudimentary tools? Rudimentary meaning like simple tools, like shovels and hammers and picks and all that stuff, right? How do you do it without these huge machines that we have nowadays? Well, that's why it's such a wonder. Now, the other fact that's really cool about the Banaue rice terraces is that if you put all of the terraces end to end, it would encompass half the planet, as in it would encircle half the planet. Isn't that mind-blowing? Wow, such a huge undertaking by the Ifugao people. So, thank you for taking this little fast fun fact journey and adventure with me to the Banaue Rice Terraces. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day.
Today, students, I'm Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. For more than a year now, you all have continued to wash your hands and watch your distance from others, and you've done a really great job wearing your masks. We know your parents and guardians have helped you to make these changes to keep yourself and your community safe. As Governor Leon Guerrero said, we are happy you are here. We want you to continue to learn and sharpen your skills with the help of PBS University. This program is the result of a collaborative effort. We couldn't do it alone. I'd like to thank the teachers and support staff of the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam for their work and their commitment to our students. I'd also like to thank you, students, for participating at home. To your parents, I'd like to thank you for taking an active role in your child's education. We are all eager to return to a time when all of us can share and study together in person. Until then, we hope you learn something new from this PBS University instruction.